gonna go underneath her ESAS to create some sort of stability. This track's gonna go on top of the patient. It's gonna loop down and under the table, but not underneath the bar that moves. That's gonna crush the patient if I raise it up or down. So I wanna make sure that this strap goes in the area where nothing moves. That's part one. Part two, I wanna make sure that the belt buckle is not onto the patient. That belt buckle will create some sort of discomfort as I tighten it up.
This kind of belt, to tighten it, you gotta pull that other plastic piece away from the clip. Mm-hmm. Rather than the other one where it's just like one rope.
Here. Sure is this strap is nice and tight. Some belts are easier to tighten than most others. I wanna make sure that it's underneath her ASIS. That's gonna create some sort of stability for the patient. All right, next part of the patient position is that resting position. Bicep to 30, abductor 30, slight external rotation. With my eyes, if I have a difficulty gauging the angles, I know right away what 90 should look like. I have an idea what 45 should look like. And 30 should be somewhere just a little bit below there. I don't want to be down over here. That looks like around 10. I'm gonna have 30 degrees flex hip, 30 degrees abduction, and a slight external rotation. There are two handholds for this assessment test. One would be just superior to her malleolus. I'm gonna grab my hands, wrapping around the tibia. I can interlock my fingers, holding her tibia. My feet is going to go into a stride stance, elbow straight, and here I'm going to lean back. As I lean back, I have a couple of things I'm going to look at. One is, does her body move? Her body, particularly from her pelvis and up. If I have a difficulty seeing that, I can, if she's okay, kind of raise up her shirt just to see her lumbar spine. There are two components that I want to look at to see if here her belly button would be like a nice landmark. Does her belly button come towards me when I provide that traction? If it does, then I know that I don't have good stability. And if I don't have good stability, I don't have traction of that hip. Should I have good stability as I pull her leg, now I can appreciate how much motion is occurring to her hip. I'm assessing two things again, the quantitative component and qualitative component. Quantitative is a little bit difficult, because when I pull her leg, I'm feeling my hands, I'm feeling my body move. That's all I could kind of feel. When I let go, I could kind of slowly feel her hip return. That's gonna be like the one of the more essential components. Some people can feel the hip glided traction out at the start. Some people cannot. Some people can feel it more at the return. I want you to pay attention, go nice and slow, get the feel. Feel the skin stretch. My hand is not moving. It's nice and stable. So I feel a little bit of tension of that muscle. And I start to kind of feel maybe the joint move. I'm not quite sure. I keep on going, keep on going, keep on going until it stops. I can't feel anything move anymore. Or until I start to see her hip move. If I see this hip drop, then I'm going way too far. Once I hit that end range, then I slowly return to get another assessment. Again, I'm looking at two things, quantitative motion and the qualitative, the end feel that I feel at the end, and then symptoms, the symptoms change. That's position one, just superior to the malleolus.